This is episode 27 of Blue Hose Break, featuring head volleyball coach Steve Benson, head men's soccer coach Nick Fanati, and head women's soccer coach Matt Smith. This episode of Blue Hose Break is brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union.
Overall went well. I think we developed some skills and really developed some team culture going into it, and we're excited about where we're going to be heading for the fall. We had 12 players involved. We brought one player in during the spring, so kind of catching her up, but it was a solid group of 12 players that were working hard all spring season on the court and, you know, in the weight room and with conditioning. So we really worked on a lot of different aspects to really improve our team going into next fall. First year at school, we kind of got to go out there and establish ourselves. So we've been very aggressive recruiting. Reagan is her first year as assistant coach, giving her an idea of that process. So we've been doing a lot of stuff together and just hit a lot of major tournaments. And been looking at a lot of kids, spending a lot of time in the gym, in the convention centers, and just get our name out there, talking to those club directors, reestablishing those relationships as I was on the men's side, but do know a lot of the women's club directors and coaches, and so just kind of reestablishing that and getting our name out there and getting PC out there in the club world, and kind of defining what we're looking for our recruiting classes as we move forward. I think we have a strong group that we committed in the fall. We have some walk-ons that we're working with that one has committed. So we got some good players coming in that are allow us to help build the program. When you lose both your starting middles, setter and oppo that were a lot of offense and blocking for a team, you got to kind of try and replace that. But we have Elise, who's been, who has some injuries and some stuff kind of going through the year, who's ready to step up, and Caitlin Cannon, who's a freshman coming in the middle, and some other players coming in. So, you know, we got to fill holes, but I feel good about because returners are coming back knowing who I am. And that's just a big plus versus what we had in the fall with everyone so new. So there's always the establishment of our systems, our culture, the way I coach. So there's a better understanding. So I'm looking forward to bringing those new kids in and having the established players help them adjust to the college game and how we do things at PC. I think our biggest thing we really tackled for this spring was weight training and conditioning. We put a real value on the weight room and conditioning. And not to say we didn't do anything in the gym, we worked on some real skills. We brought in some individual time, brought in some video, gave some ideas of really making ourselves better on little skills and really honing in those things. So we established this, the system and kind of our way we do things during the fall. Now is a chance to really kind of work on those little details and work on little mechanics and nuances to take the returning players' game to the next level. I hope a winning and exciting season. I think the girls are excited. They're all in and really excited. And I think just building from what we established in 23 to going into 24. I think we have a nice schedule, some tournaments, and we're just looking forward to that opportunity to go and compete again and really move up in the conference rankings and compete at that high level and get to the championship and get to the conference tournament and hopefully a championship where anything can happen.
Typically your spring season, you the first transition, you know, is learning to live without the seniors, right? And so we had 9 players who are graduating either in December or May. And so, you know, the group being able to kind of find themselves, establish new leadership in those roles, forge a new identity. Right. And so that was the first kind of transition piece. And then secondly, we brought in 4 players in second semester through the transfer route. And so being able to acclimate those guys into our culture, into our game model and our relationships, that was a very, very important piece. And I think finally, just having more time, you know, with our players, you know, day in and day out, training, meetings, video analysis, very productive spring for us. We've had a lot of change, two large senior classes. straight away. One, when I got here, I lost a lot of players through graduation, and then obviously we just had a class to graduate. So from that standpoint, we've had a lot of new players come into the program. I thought the first recruiting class was very good and validated through much recognition, and so yeah, I think we're in good shape. Super excited about the fall and the class that's coming in. Well, certainly not vertically, a lot. I mean, an immense level of growth. I feel going from an assistant coach role to a head coach role, and it's been very gratifying to be with the boys. We just wrapped up individual meetings, and obviously the plan is for all of our players to be in an environment, a good environment, training and playing this summer, and whether the internationals are going back home and kind of reacclimating with their clubs, and the domestic guys are here in the States. They all are committed to a team. The summer is important for us, just from that standpoint, right? So, Zooms together, continue to try and build culture and build relationships over the summer with the guys. Our strength staff puts together, a strength training and conditioning program for the players. They're well aware of that and how they can fit that into their playing schedule. But you're right, the periodization when we return to campus is very condensed and compact. And so we just got to make sure that the guys understand the importance of being fit, being sharp when they arrive on campus, so that we can kind of hit the ground running, in preparation for, as you mentioned, the exhibitions.
They're starving for it. I think I would take it even more than hungry, because it's they've put in all the work that they need to, and they focus day by day, because winning isn't about necessarily the result, right? Winning is about what you do in order to get there. And something we talked about a lot was winning was being better today than you were yesterday, every day. Like, that's winning. And so, but that also brings in literal, actual wins and losses as well. So we've been really process driven, but we're driven towards the goal of winning. We make no bones about that our goal is to not go undefeated, but our goal is to win every game. It's two very different things. And one of them is more process driven as compared to result driven. The girls have really bought into that, and it shows. It shows, because every day of training we had a winner and a loser. In some piece of training, everything we did. So, they really bought into that, and it created a lot of excitement. And it's a great buzzword, right? It's a great buzz phrase that, hey, we're going to win now, and that kind of thing. But what they started to learn was what that means. Come this fall, winning on Wednesday and Saturday in the Big South Conference isn't about Wednesday and Saturday. It's actually what you do on the other days to lead into what those results are. And that doesn't even mean on the field. One thing that we really tried to get across to them this spring was, make a decision every day that makes you a better soccer player, right? But that doesn't necessarily mean about the ball. That may mean getting ahead in classes so that you can be focused in training, right? Proper recovery, proper rest, proper nutrition, proper hydration, something like that every day to kind of key on to be better. And when you do that, you're able to chip away, right? And, we don't want to start at the finish line. We want to start at where we are. Because if that's the case, if you do that and you really buy into that idea, then when you get to the finish line, you get to look back at the journey and get to really appreciate where you are a lot more than if you just start at the finish line. So we're very process driven, and just trying to get better every day somehow, right? How we can get better every day, and understanding that that's all very individualized, and really being a little bit more self-aware about what that means to me and what that means to each player individually has been a big emphasis this spring. We inherited four players that had already signed. We were able to go through the recruiting process with them and meet them, and they're great people, good players. Very satisfied for what that is. And then we were able to add four more currently, and really excited about that, and just good people. Something that I never want to change about what Coach Purcell did was the type of people that he brought in. It's something that I've carried with me everywhere I've been, is that, people win games, not players. Right. And so we've really focused on the type of people and the type of culture that we want to build and sustain really through this, while also looking for different attributes that may lend itself to more my style and things like that. But recruiting has been great. It's been busy. It's been an interesting cycle. The transfer portal is about to open up here in a week, which could also bring some new faces. But the characteristics for what a PC person is still the same. And that hasn't changed over my 15-year absence. And that's going to be really what's important, because we want people that want to bleed blue and garnet, and then want to fight and die for the school and fight and die for the badge. And so, you know, it's something that we take a lot of pride in, and the people that we recruit, we also want them to have the same pride, you know, with where they are and kind of what they have and where we're trying to go. So it's been fun. It's been fun to kind of cast the net, because, you know, I think that there are PC people that don't know they're PC people out there, because they, you know, maybe they haven't heard about us or whatever. I think that women's basketball success, I think, kind of, you know, we even got some emails after that saying, hey, you know, we saw the women's basketball team on March Madness and things like that. So that's always good to get eyeballs and giving us some traction with some people that maybe wouldn't know about us otherwise. You know, so it's been a fun process, and it's been something that's been definitely a point of emphasis for me and Kirsten this spring, is to add to the squad and you know, try to carry us forward.